Ladies and gentlemen, introducing for one night only, a not-so-young man with a dream. A dream to write and record a song good enough to make it on a record, even if that record is the only one produced. Chuck Cheap Buried and that sudden numbing tragedy, Glee Club!
I was introduced to music at an early age, singing in the shower, banging out notes on my grandparents' piano, taking violin lessons, or trying to emulate my older brother, who seemed to be able to play any instrument that he picked up. By 15, I had my own guitar. By 18, I had commandeered my brother's drum kit, and by my mid-20s, I owned an odd collection of stringed and keyboard instruments, an off-pitch voice, and a shoddy four-track recorder. I spent a lot of my free time figuring out and recording versions of my favorite songs and penning my own tunes, none of which sounded as good on tape as they did in my head. When I had a child at age 36, I basically stopped playing for a decade, but I still found ways to include recorded music in my classroom. Now, at age 51, I feel that creative itch again, and I feel I have the time and the drive to do something for which I would be proud. What does it take to make that kind of recording? I have the instruments. I have the experience of recording. What else do I need? As it turns out, a lot. I was in a few bands in my youth, but by the time I was in college, I spent most of my recording time working alone and putting down tracks by myself, one on top of another. I never learned to play off of someone else's creativity. So one thing that I need to do in the next year is to find some musicians in my area and begin to play with them. Music is always so much stronger as a collaborative effort. And although my plan is to record on my own, that does not mean that I need to be alone as a musician all the time. Secondly, I need professional help. No, not that kind, though that might not be a bad idea as well, but the kind that a music teacher can give me. I've played the guitar and drums for 35 years, but never really got better after year 5. Drum lessons are a must. I learned to play listening to Keith Moon, but no one can truly play like he did. So I need some of the basics that I never bothered to learn. The same goes for the guitar, especially when it comes to picking notes and writing lead guitar solos. Not that I want to be Stevie Ray Vaughan, but it would be good to play a solo like Freddie Johnston every once in a while. Lastly, as I go through 2 to 3 years of lessons, I need some good recording equipment. I just received my first good mic last Christmas and a Fender Stratocaster this spring, but I need a good computer and software to record and mix on, and several other mics, plus a new electric amplifier. That will take some savings, so I will need to budget every month and build up the capital to spend on my own small recording studio. I will also need to do the research on what is best for my purposes. This might be something that my music teachers and fellow musicians can help me to do. Their knowledge can become my knowledge. Month by month, year by year, my musical talents will grow, and so will my ability to record that talent in a way I have never done before. Do I want to write a new song? Maybe. Perhaps I will dive into the 50-plus songs I've written over the years, finding one good enough to rework and remake into my masterpiece. The process alone of going through them and doing this would be an exercise in patience, vision, and creativity. So, Where do I see my musical hobby in 5 years? Experimenting in my basement studio, playing out my newly honed skills, and sharing my ideas with like-minded musicians, I see my goal met and my song written, recorded, and enjoyed, if only by me and a select few. That's all I need. That's all I want.